Hello, my dear students. How are you? I hope all of you are safe and fine at home. In the previous class, we finished our story talk.
How is your story? It was very interesting. All the things, if you think what happened when all the plants, animals and the things were started talking around us, we are excited and we are upset. The plants, animals and the things, even a stone were started talking. That was an imaginary story. It was an imaginary story that was happened in Africa. And one day a man started to digging a yam from his garden. So the yam started to talking. Finally, you are here. You started to digging. That make me disturbance. So leave me alone. So the farmer surprised and he looks around, but no one is there to talk with you. So he looks his cow, he saw his cow that was cheeping and it says nothing. So his dog started talking. It was not cow, that is your yam. That say, leave me alone. Listen the words from yam. Then suddenly the farmer surprised and he become very angry because his dog started talking. His dog had never talked before. So to the farmer that was very he not like his tone to talk, tone of talking. So he take a branch from palm tree not to beat that dog, you know, to beat his pet dog. So when suddenly the palm tree said, put down that branch, and then he again surprised and he become upset because even the tree was started talking and it say, put that branch down. So he threw that branch and that branch says, man, put me down softly. Then the branch from palm tree says, put me down softly, do softly. So he put that branch down gently on a stone. So he take that branch and it put in on a stone. Then the stone was started talking, hey, take that thing off me. Then the stone replied, take it from me and take that thing off me. So he become upset and he become surprised and he become frightened. Because all the things were started talking, even dog started talking, palm tree, stone, stick, all the things were things in his garden were started talking. So he become very frightened and he started to run away from that garden. On the way of garden, he met a fisherman with a fishing trap, and then the fisherman said, "What happened? What happened? Why are you running?" Then the farmer explained the story. So the fisherman become, he laughed and is that, and he replied, "Is that all?" The man with fish trap asked, "Is that so frightening? It became very frightening. That was frightening. It was a silly matter," the fisherman said. The fisherman told to the farmer, "It was silly. That was a silly matter. So It was not a matter to running. Then suddenly the fish trap from the fisherman started to talking. Did you take it off the stone? Then the fish trap says, did he take that stick from the stone? Then suddenly what happened? Yes, fisherman's fish trap started talking and it asked to the fisherman, man, then the farmer did take it off from the stone. Then the fisherman become frightened because his trap started talking and he threw that fish trap and he also followed the farmer. He started running with that farmer. On the way, they were met a weaver with a bundle of cloth and he asked, and the weaver asked, why are you running? What happened? Then farmer and fisherman explained what happened. After hearing that, fisherman replied, that's nothing to get excited about. No reason at all. It was not a not an important thing to excitement. No reason at all. It was an silly matter. So then, oh, yes, it is his bundle of clothes, said. If it happened to you, you'd run too? Then his bundle of clothes started talking and it says, if it happened to you, you never run? Then the weaver become frightened because his bundle of cloth started talking and he threw that bundle of cloth and he followed the fisherman and farmer and he started running. They were running through the village. Then a man who were bathing in a river and he saw these the three men, fisherman, farmer and weaver. He asked, what happened? Are you chasing a gazelle? Are you hunting a gazelle? This is a type of deer in Africa. So he asked them, are you chasing a gazelle? Then they stopped and they explained what happened to them and why they are running. So then the man with the bathing said, is that why you are running? The man with man in the river asked. Then it is not a matter to running, he said. The man bathing man said, it was not a matter, it is a silly matter. He also take it as a silly. So but suddenly then his water from the river started talking. Is that, well, wouldn't you run if you were in their position? The river said. Then the river said, if you are in that position, you never run. Then bathing man become frightened, and he jumped out of the water and began to run with the others. Then they ran away through the main street of the village and they reached the house of village chief. The chief's village chief servant brought a stool and not to sit that chief to hear their complaints. All the men, fishermen, bathing men, weaver and farmer explained their stories, their trouble stories to the chief, their complaints, their stories to the chief. After he patiently listened their complaints and he became very angry and he replied, get out from this house before I will punish you. Before punishing, get out from this house, he shouted them with angry, and he said that it was a wild story and it was an imaginary story. It never happened. It was an imaginary story, and he get out I get out these mans, and these mans were went away from the house, and the village chief mumbled to himself, what a horror story is this, this man's nonsense, this man's were foolish man's foolish, and it make upset the community and disturb the peace of the community, he mumbled, and he take it as a silly matter and imaginary story of these mans. Then what happened? Finally his stool was started to talking. Then the stool said, fantastic, is not it? His stool said, he imagine a talking yam. And then his stool says, imagine a talking yam. His stool was started talking. All the things of that village were started talking. That was the story talk. If you get the idea, the plants, stones, a stick, even the stool were started talking. River, all the things around that village were started talking like man. Like human being, the things and the plants and animals, birds were started talking. That was the story talk. Okay, dear students, now our story is over. Now we can move for our exercise part. Which is the first exercise? Let us understand who said these to whom. What has been done for you? One is there. Example for example, you know, to done for this work is there, and we complete remaining sentences. First, we give a dialogue and we write who said to these words to whom. Who says these words to whom? First, well, at last you are here. You never weeded me, but now you have come around with your digging stick. Go away and leave me alone. Who said these words? Yes, the yam. One of the yam from the garden said these words to the farmer. One of the yam from the garden said this word to the farmer. The answer, the yam said this word to a countryman who was a farmer. Yam said these words. Then next dialogue, man put me down softly. Man put me down softly. Who said these words? Yes, when the farmer took his knife and it cut a branch from palm tree not to beat his dog because he don't like the tool or the way of talking of his dog. So he take a branch from palm tree not to beat the beat that dog. So the palm tree says started talking, and so he become upset, and he threw that branch. So branch of palm tree started talking, and he said, put me down softly. So this is the words from the palm branch. So right there, the palm branch said these words to the farmer. The palm branch said these words to the farmer. Then next dialogue, is that all? Is that so frightening? Who said these words to the farmer? Yes, fisherman said these words to the farmer. When the farmer is running and the fisherman, so he was running, so he asked what happened. Then the farmer explained to the fisherman, and after hearing these words, he replied, these words, is that all? Is that so frightening? So right there, the fisherman said these words to the farmer. The fisherman said these words to the farmer. Then next dialogue,
Where are you going in such a rush? Where are you going in such a rush? Who said these words? Yes, Weaver said these words. These words to fishermen and farmer when they ran through village. The Weaver met them and he asked to them, "Why are you running?" These are dialogue from the Weaver. Then right there, the Weaver said these words to the farmer and fisherman. Right there, the Weaver said these words to the farmer and fisherman. The Weaver said these words to the farmer and fisherman. Then next dialogue. Now this is really a wild story. Who said these words? Yes, the village chief, who said these words to the fisherman, farmer, weaver and the man who bathing to the river. Village chief said these words to the farmer, fisherman, the man who bathing and the weaver. When they explained their trouble stories to the village chief. Then write the answer. The village chief said these words to the farmer, the fisherman, the weaver and the man who was bathing in the river. The village chief said these words to the farmer, fisherman, the weaver and the man who was bathing in the river. This is the answer. Then the last dialogue. Fantastic. Is not it? Imagine a talking yam. Fantastic. Is not it? Imagine a talking yam. Who said these words? Yes, the stool said these words to the village chief. Answer is that the stool said these words to the village chief. The stool says these words to the village chief. Right there. Okay, dear students, now you have a homework. Writing practice is the homework for you. The question, imagine you are a villager who witnessed the whole story of the countryman. You wish to send the story to a newspaper. For this, you have to write a report of the story. Keep the following points in mind while you write the report in your notebook. Include date, time and place where the event occurred. Think of suitable title. Describe the event in simple sentences. You may answer the following questions here. Who were involved? What happened? How did it happen? Present your ideas and information correctly. Concluded by giving a hint of what may occur in the future. Write your name. Dear students, you try to write in simple sentence like this. First you find out a title, Wonders of the World. Then you can write the place which is the place, Accra, again the village of Gulf of Guinea. Then you write on 14th October 2020, a man was digging in his garden. Suddenly, one of the yam started talking, and then his dog started talking. And write like this: what happened in that chapter? You write simple. You write in your words, and make a report. Report and write in your notebook and send me it. Try to write a report using simple sentences. You choose your language, simple language, and write a suitable title to the report. Okay, and send me it. Okay, dear students. you must read the chapter, or then only you can write the report. Read the chapter again and again and try to write the newspaper report. Then send me it. Okay. Now we can wind up our class. See you next class. Bye.